Hi friends, welcome to my channel, and in today's video let us learn about the cross merchandising in retail. So firstly we will define the cross merchandising term and we will see how it is done, and also we will see examples of various categories. So let us define what is cross merchandising. Cross merchandising is the display of the opposite products together to earn the additional revenue for the store. Here the products from the different categories are kept together at one place for increasing the sale. It is also called as placing the complementary items alongside one another. So why cross merchandising is done? The idea is simple. If the customer is looking for one of the item, then they might also need the other. This type of merchandising is incredibly common in the grocery store. We have to note one important thing here. That is, it is important to research customer preference, taking seasonal trends into account, and most importantly, pair items that are often used together. So friends, cross merchandising is also known as secondary product placement. It saves the time for the customer and increases the revenue for the retailer. It is truly a win-win situation for both. Friends, here we must also note that cross-merchandising product placement is often described as selling a solution instead of just selling one product. For example, when you visit any well-established retail electronics store like Reliance Digital or Tata Chroma and inquire for a laptop, then the sales associate will also try to sell antivirus, extended warranty, Microsoft Office, and accessories like hard disk, mouse, and keyboard with the laptop. This is called providing a complete solution to the customer. So how can we do this? Yes, we can do this by cross-merchandising laptop with accessories and other services available in the store. So friends, what cross-merchandising will do to the customers and the retailers? The first point is, as we discussed earlier, cross-merchandise will increase the sales for the retailer and provides value for the customer. The second thing that the cross-merchandising will do is that it will remind customers of a need. That is, it will help customers to realize that they need another product to go along with their primary purchase. For example, if you place a belt beside trouser display, then the customer might get tempted to buy the belt along the trouser. The third point is saving customers time. That is, retailers will save the customer time walking through the whole store. A retailer might display a complete grooming kit like face wash, moisturizer, talcum powder, and deodorant together. A customer can pick the complete package and thus save the time browsing each product individually in the store. The fourth point is, cross merchandising will help introducing customer to a new product. That is, retailers can introduce shoppers to a useful and popular products by displaying those products at an unexpected or prominent places around the store. For example, you can place a newly launched wafers beside the beverage section. This will help customers to know the newly launched product. So friends, after understanding what is cross merchandising and its significance, now let us see the examples in various categories. Starting with apparel category, cross merchandising can be done in following ways. That is, displaying belt with the trousers, displaying hankies with the trousers, or displaying tie with a formal shirt, or displaying socks with a footwear, and displaying of deodorants with a casual shirts or casual trousers. So now coming to the FMCG category, we can place wafers and chips alongside beverages, toothbrush beside the toothpaste section, and combs beside the hair oil section. So now let's see the examples of electronic section. So in electronic section, we can place screen guards with mobiles, hard disk and mouse with laptops, wireless headphones, Bluetooth headphones with mobile phones, soundbar with high-end televisions, Bluetooth speaker with laptops. And now in general merchandise section, we can place batteries with toys, balls with melamine plates, and pens with books. Friends, now we have seen all the examples of the cross merchandising. Let us conclude the video by knowing the important tips of cross merchandising. So the first important tip is, the opposite product should be sensibly displayed for the customers so that they will be able to relate them. For example, you can display hanky with the formal shirt. You cannot display a scarf with the formal shirt. That doesn't make any sense. The second tip is, the merchandise should be neatly arranged without giving a cluttered look at the store. That means whatever you are cross merchandising, that should be neatly displayed at the store. The third point is, the merchandise must complement each other to create a desired impact. And the fourth and the final point is, the retailer should make sure that the products have some logical connections with each other. So with this, let's conclude this video. If you like this video, then please hit the like button and please subscribe to my channel to get such more updates in the future. And thanks for watching.